First of all, we're really happy and honored to be here working with the WDR Orchestra. I first worked with them in the mid-1990s, but it's been a while since we've been back.
There's a feeling of a cycle that happened when I arrived in this room, because not a lot of the walls and just the general atmosphere of the room has changed, and it's a home. It's a place where a lot of creativity, a lot of musical excellence takes place, and I like being in here. It's very inviting for something special to happen.
I'm the chief conductor of the WDR Big Band, which is really a big chunk of my musical life at this point. And the other big chunk is being in the Yellow Jackets, which I've now been a 30-year member of. So it's very meaningful to me, as well as to the, I think, everyone involved, that these two entities come together, you know, and sort of revisit what we did 25 years ago, but in an updated version.
The difference between playing as a quartet as opposed to with a big band, it's almost like brand new music to my ears. A whole new sound that's just so refreshing and powerful.
The four of us together as a unit create the music, even though Bob Mincer and Russell Ferrante are the two prolific composers in the band. Dane and I are just keeping up with their writing, composing abilities.
Bob arranged both of the new tunes, and I got an opportunity to arrange one of the older Yellow Jackets tunes called Coherence, which we haven't done yet, so I'm anxious to hear how that comes out.
This has been a great experience, obviously, to have this sort of big band treatment done to the songs, and it's almost a form of watching your children grow up, if you will.
One Day is a tune of Bob Mincer's, brand new song, very challenging to play. Bob always writes these unusual syncopations, so you have to pay close attention.
The Yellow Jackets as a quartet is really sort of established, well-oiled machine, as is the WDR Big Band. So why not bring these two entities together? And so far what I'm hearing, this is a really good idea, and it's working out very well.
The thread that continues through the years is the commitment to high musicianship in both organizations, and there's a certain bit of responsibility that comes with that, but that's what makes experiences like this so fun, because you can make something really special, something really meaningful happen.
It's a different thing when you're used to playing as a quartet to add a big band. We all need to leave space for everyone else. So it's always about listening and doing whatever the music requires.
I ordered one larger instrument, the bass drum. I normally play a 20-inch diameter bass drum. However, I'm very familiar and have often played before a 22-inch diameter bass drum, which is what I'm using for the WDR performance. And it just allows me to provide that foundation easier for my bandmates to feel and listen to.
I'm doubling a lot of the parts the big band plays, so I have to attack when they attack and release when they release, and you have to be like one, you have to breathe together. So that's one of the big challenges.
if you take this ensemble, which is, you know, we've played together a lot over the years, and you then put a big band on top of that, that's something really powerful.
You know, a really good cake could be ruined with terrible icing. I'm a dessert expert here. But a cake with really good icing, the cake being the band and WDR Big Band is the wonderful icing around it.